So you want to set up Google Analytics e-commerce tracking on your WooCommerce store. You're in the right place. I'm going to show you the easiest way to get up and running. You'll walk through the steps to send e-commerce events to Google Analytics with the help of Google Tag Manager. The first step to tracking transactions and other e-commerce events from WooCommerce is to install Google Tag Manager on our WordPress site. So let's start by heading to WordPress. I already have WooCommerce installed on my demo WordPress site, so let's select Plugins and then Add New. Now let's search for Google Tag Manager. Let's install the GTM for WordPress plugin. And let's activate the plugin. Now let's click Settings. We need to start by entering our container ID from Google Tag Manager. So let's head to Google Tag Manager to find this. We're looking at a new Google Tag Manager container that I've just created, so there are no tags in the container yet. I'm going to cover the steps to add Google Analytics to Google Tag Manager. You'll need to follow these steps if you're getting started with Google Tag Manager for the first time. If you already have Google Analytics configured, then you can skip ahead. To add our Google Analytics tag, let's select Add a New Tag. Let's name the tag Google Tag GA4 Page View. And let's select Tag Configuration. Now let's choose Google Tag as the tag type. And we need to enter our measurement ID. Let's head to Google Analytics to find this. We need to navigate to Admin, then select Data Streams. You can also find your data streams by selecting Data Collection and Modification on the left, and then select Data Streams. Now we need to open the data stream for our WordPress site. And we can copy the measurement ID. Now let's head back to Google Tag Manager. You can paste the measurement ID straight into the tag, but I recommend creating a variable instead. This means you can easily reuse the measurement ID in multiple tags. And if you ever need to update the measurement ID, you can just update the variable and all of your tags will be up to date. To do this, let's click the variable icon. And let's click the plus sign on the top right corner. Let's name our variable GA4 measurement ID. And now let's select Variable Configuration. We choose Constant as the variable type. And paste our measurement ID as the value. Now let's save our variable. Next, we select Triggering. And select the Initialization All Pages trigger. This will mean that Google Analytics is added to all of the pages where we've added Google Tag Manager. You can preview the changes, but I'm happy with the tag I've added, so I'm going to click Submit. And then Publish. This means we've now published the Google tag to our website, and this will send page views and other events to our reports in Google Analytics. The next step is to add Google Tag Manager to our WordPress site, so we need to copy the container ID. We can find this at the top. It starts with GTM and then a dash. Let's copy this. Now let's head back to WordPress. And let's paste our container ID. Make sure there isn't a space at the start or end of the container ID, as this will cause problems. Now, if you want to continue using another plugin to add Google Tag Manager to your website, you'll need to change the container code option to off. For example, if you're using Google's Sitekit plugin to add Google Tag Manager and you want to continue using that plugin, then just make sure you change this to off. Since I'm adding Google Tag Manager to WordPress for the first time, I'm not using another plugin to add Google Analytics, so let's ensure this is set to on. Now let's click Save Changes. And let's select the Integration tab and choose WooCommerce. Let's enable the Track Enhanced e-commerce option and click Save Changes. So far, we've added the plugin to our WordPress site and we've added our Google Tag Manager container ID. This means Google Tag Manager is ready to capture details about our transactions and other e-commerce events from WooCommerce. The next step is to configure Google Tag Manager to pass all of this information to Google Analytics. Let's head to Google Tag Manager. To report on the way people engage with our store and purchase in Google Analytics, we'll need to set up a tag and trigger in our container. If you're new to Google Tag Manager and want to learn more about how you can manage your tags, then take a moment to check out my other tutorials and resources. I've included links in the description below this video. Basically, the plugin we installed in WordPress adds a data layer that contains details about the products people view, the actions they take, and when they make a purchase. We can then capture this information and pass it to Google Analytics. Since we need to configure a few different things in Google Tag Manager, I want to save you some time. So I've included a link in the description below this video that lets you download a pre-configured container. Let's import these elements into Google Tag Manager. To do this, let's select Admin at the top. Then Import Container. And now let's choose the pre-configured container. I'm going to choose Existing to use my current workspace. And then I'm going to choose Default. And I'm going to select Merge to keep the other tags, variables, and triggers that are already in Google Tag Manager. Now I'm going to click Confirm. We've now imported a new tag, trigger, and variables to send e-commerce details to Google Analytics. Let's select Tags. We can see a new tag has been added. This is a GA4 event tag. And this tag will send all of the different e-commerce events to Google Analytics. Now let's select Triggers. We can see there is a new trigger. This will look for any e-commerce events so that our GA4 event tag will fire. This will include purchases along with item views, add to carts, and more. And let's select Variables. We can see there are a number of user-defined variables that will get the values from the data layer. We're not going to use these as the GA4 event tag will automatically capture this information. However, I've included these in the container because you can use them if you want to send e-commerce information to other platforms. For example, if you want to send purchase details to Facebook, Microsoft, or another platform. Okay, so now we need to configure the tag. So let's head back to Tags. We already configured the Google tag to send page views and other events to GA4. If you don't have this tag in your container yet, then skip back in this video and watch that first. Now we need to configure the tag we imported to use our GA4 measurement ID. So let's select the GA4 e-commerce tag. And select Tag Configuration. Now we need to remove the default variable. And let's click the variable icon. And let's select the GA4 measurement ID variable we created. Now we can save the tag. Before we test this, let's navigate to Variables. And let's delete the variable we removed from the GA4 event tag. How are you going so far? Have you run into any issues or has everything gone smoothly? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. Okay, now we're ready to test things out. So let's click Preview. We enter the URL of our WooCommerce store and click Connect. We can view a product. And add the product to our cart. Now before we make a purchase, let's see what's already been sent to Google Analytics. Let's select the Tag Assistant tab. And we can see that our GA4 e-commerce tag has fired a number of times. Let's select the GA4 measurement ID at the top. We can now see all of the different events that have been sent to Google Analytics. And we can see this includes View Item and Add to Cart events. Now let's head back to the site and check out. We enter our details and complete the purchase. We can now see the confirmation page, so let's select the Tag Assistant tab again. We can see additional events have been sent to Google Analytics, and there is a purchase event too. Let's check the purchase event has come through to Google Analytics, so let's head to Google Analytics. And let's navigate to Admin. Select Data Display. And then Debug View. We can now see all of the e-commerce events, including the purchase event, have come through. And we can select this to see additional details. We've now added Google Tag Manager to our WooCommerce store, and we're sending e-commerce events to Google Analytics. If Google Analytics was already installed on your WordPress site, then consider removing the existing tag. If you don't, then you'll probably see duplicate page views and other events appear in your reports. So I recommend migrating any other tracking you've configured to Google Tag Manager. Once you've tested your tags and you're happy everything is working correctly, you'll need to publish your changes in Google Tag Manager. Let's head to Google Tag Manager to do this. We just need to click Submit, name our version, and click Publish. Our e-commerce tag, trigger, and variables have now been published to our live WooCommerce store. You'll find data appears in the standard reports after 24 hours. You'll then be able to use the monetization reports and build your own exploration reports in Google Analytics. If you'd like me to create a video covering the e-commerce reports, I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And there's more to learn about Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics, so please take a moment to subscribe to this channel. You will be notified when we release new tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.